In World War II, the Allies ended the deadly threat of the Nazi war machine, but only temporarily. Learn why German dreams of dominance didn't die with Hitler. Next, on The Key of David with Gerald Flurry.
Greetings, everyone. Angela Merkel just recently retired as the Chancellor of Germany, and she made some statements that really ought to shake the nations of this world if they understood history of Germany, which most people do not, and it means very little, if anything, to them. But we have been prophesying about this event that she's talking about and these events specifically for over 75 years, for over 75 years. Now, I'm telling you what she talked about in this statement that seems so insignificant to a lot of people is really going to change violently the history of this world, for bad for a little while, but for good forever. And that's the kind of prophecy that it is. And I can prove all of that to you. I'll tell you, we just have to see what God means here and take it all, look at the secular history and then biblical history and see what this means. It may seem insignificant to a lot of people, but let me tell you, it is directly connected to the second coming of Jesus Christ. Directly. And it's a sign of what is coming very, very quickly. Let me give you comments that she made, and this is from the Telegraph newspaper, and here's what it says. Angela Merkel admitted she was helpless, quote unquote, to resist pressure from German business to support the Nord Stream 2 gas pipeline, Donald Tusk claimed at the weekend. The decision to build Nord Stream 2 was Angela Merkel's biggest mistake, said Mr. Tusk. Who is this man? Who was a key figure in the Brexit negotiations as president of the European Council. So this is not some insignificant person, a very important leader over in Germany. And Mrs. Merkel, it goes on to say, has consistently defended the controversial gas pipeline in the face of intense opposition from the U.S. and Germany's EU allies. But Mr. Tusk claimed she had told him privately that she had no choice. No choice. She was helpless. No choice. What does that mean? No choice because of the pressure she was under from German business leaders. Now, that sounds really quite strange to a lot of people, but it's really one of the biggest secrets in this world, and it is fulfilling Bible prophecy in an amazing way. And again, just think about helpless to resist that pressure from these business leaders. What does that mean? No choice because of all that pressure from these business leaders. Can you tell me what that means? Can we really understand that? That's not something we ought to just pass over quickly, but we need to look into this and see what is happening. And I'll tell you, we're going to be shocked, and many people are going to be somewhat, I think, intensely frightened by it. This is serious trouble that she's talking about, although if you don't know German history and Bible prophecy, you really won't understand that much about it. Notice another comment here. This is taken from our correspondence course, lesson 3 of the what we call our old correspondence course. And notice what it says. No defeat is final. Defeats are simply lessons to be learned in preparation for the next and greater attack, said German General von Stupnagel in 1944. That's just at the end of World War II. And notice what he said. This is a quote. Here are his words. And this is from a general. In the next World War, which should take place within 25 years, the same mistake should not be made. The principal adversary will be the United States, and the entire effort must be concentrated against this country from the beginning. Our defeat in the present war need not be considered except as an incident in the triumphal march of Germany toward conquest of the world. Have they really got into an ambition like that, and are they still trying to fulfill it? And then he concluded it by saying, Deutschland über alles, or Germany over all. What is he talking about, and what is this all about? It means what? Does it, that America is Germany's number one enemy now? Let me show you a prophecy that talks about this. Revelation 17 and verse 8. The beast that you saw was and is not. Notice that, because, well, it went underground. How did it do that? The beast that you saw was and is not and shall ascend out of the bottomless pit and go into perdition or destruction. Well, that's, see again, it's bad news and it's good news. It's going to go into perdition, destruction forever. But it's called the bottomless pit. Now, that's not the best translation, but it just means in a pit where it just keeps going on and on and on, and you can never take care of the problem in that pit. It just seems like this underground activity, it just keeps going on and on forever. It is a better translation is just the underground. Germany went underground. How did they do that? The last part of verse 8 says, they behold the beast that was and is not and yet is. It is not. In other words, it's underground. Verse 10, and there are seven kings, five are fallen and one is. That's when Hitler was on the scene. One is. And that's when Herbert W. Armstrong was on the scene prophesying about this very verse and how it was Adolf Hitler and the Holy Roman Empire that he was talking about. And one is, and the other is not yet come there, but now that other has come. It's here. And this is all about to just come splashing onto the world scene very quickly. It's going to happen. And when he comes, he must continue a short space. Thank God for that. Verse 12, and the 10 horns which you saw are 10 kings, which have received no kingdom as yet, but received power as kings 1 hour with the beast. These have one mind and shall give their power and strength unto the beast. Well, then notice the good news. Notice what it's connected to. These same people, these 10 kings, shall make war with the Lamb, and the Lamb shall overcome them, for he is Lord of lords and King of kings, and they that are with him are called and chosen and faithful. See, Germany is going to lead 10 kings. They're going to be leading it all, and there's going to be some people that are called and chosen and faithful that are going to be proclaiming this message to the world. God is going to get the message out as a warning to this world. Now, if you look at verse 17, it says, for God has put it in their hearts to fulfill His will. Now, why would God do that? Why would God want them to fulfill His will that way? Well, it has to do with our sins. God is very much concerned about our sins. I'll just read you one or two more quotes. I just have to help you to see this history. Here's what the Correspondence Corps said 57 years ago, leading German industrialists. Leading German industrialists, that's what Chancellor Merkel was talking about. German industrialists, German leaders, German business leaders. The leading German industrialists founded a society which they called Pan-German League. Its slogan was Deutschland über alles, Germany over all. They utilized the trademark made in Germany as proof of German superiority. Behind their commercial and business methods was a central permanent strategy with the goal of conquering the world. There it is again. Their goal was to conquer the world, and still is. And you can prove that by their own history. It was they who were largely responsible for inducing the Kaiser to enter World War I. It was they who were behind World War II, cooperating with a German militarist, and the secret movement started by General Ludendorff, who selected Adolf Hitler as his stooge and protege. These same industrialists financed the Nazi movement and actually elevated Hitler to power. Senator Kilgore's report at that time to the Senate Military Affairs Committee calls attention to this fact. Hitler was merely a tool. He was the rabble-rouser they needed to sway the masses of German people to get behind their fanatical plot for world rule. Now, that's exactly what Angela Merkel was talking about. These business industrialists knew if they lost the war, they would just blame Adolf Hitler, and then they themselves would be free to continue on for a third round. In other words, they started World War I, and they started World War II, and they're going to start World War III, according to your Bible. A terrible prophecy, but it nevertheless is there. We often talk about it as Armageddon, but it's certainly prophesied in your Bible in many prophecies, like 100 of them. Now, these industrial barons, well, after World War was over, they went underground. They went into the bottomless pit. They just keep doing it over and over and over, and you never can clear the pit of this evil. They just keep right on coming until Jesus Christ personally stops this group of people. So, I mean, from the beginning, these German industrialists have led a double life. Now, you need to think about that. They've led a double life. If you look at their past, they were secretly collaborating fully with the Nazis, and then they went on to collaborate with them after World War II. And I'll show you evidence of that. There's ample evidence of it. Plenty of evidence. See, whatever, it's, again, it doesn't matter what you call it, but it's really a very dangerous event. Industrialists like Krupp and many other outstanding German businessmen actively establishing great factories really all over the world to finance World War III. Can you believe that? Well, I'll show you there's a great document that we have declassified that says exactly that. But the Nazis went underground May 16, 1943. That's 2 years before the war ended. You know why they went underground? Because they knew Hitler was going to lose, and they went underground. And Hitler got all the blame, and the people that used him as a puppet, well, nobody expects them. Why, they're well-dressed businessmen, and they have businesses all over the world, and they're still supporting that same goal that the Nazis had in World War II. That Nazi spirit is still there. Quick short quote here. The government of modern history began to function underground. Today, the Nazis are working feverishly on ultra-modern weapons and other projects. In 1951, notice this, Dr. Adenauer, ex-chancellor of West Germany, admitted the presence of 134 former Nazis who served under Hitler in high echelons in his Bonn government. In other words, Dr. Adenauer, when he was chancellor, said there were 134 former Nazis in his government, and we supported him and said nothing about this. Dictators, 10 dictators are coming on the scene, and let me show you something else that is really astounding as well. In 1996, there was a World War II intelligence document that they made public, and it shocked the public. And the document detailed an August 1944 meeting between top German industrialists, and it reveals a secret post-war plan to restore the Nazis to power. Several of Germany's elite industries were represented, including Messerschmitt and Volkswagen Werk. You've heard of those industries? Surely you have. They are pretty famous today. But do you know what's going on in those industries, according to this document? The U.S. government kept this classified for 50 years. And then in 1996, they declassified it. And many people in the world were stunned, but then on the other hand, the media didn't do much about it, and so people just forgot about it and went on about their business. See, these men that were underground, they posed as technical experts in industries, but they are still supporting this goal of what Germany had in World War I and World War II. It's the same spirit. Did you know that Germany today has an economy twice the size of Russia? And Russia helped us defeat Germany in World War II? That's quite an accomplishment in a short amount of time. How did they do it? Well, they already had these great businesses going even before Germany was in a pile of rubble. But they brought it back quickly because they had business all over the world. And we still don't understand how it happened. Several people have said that's dangerous when you look at how quickly this happened. But nobody is willing to do anything about it. And if you want to look at how we denazified the Germans in World War II, after 2 years, they gave this program to the Germans themselves. And it was a farce. Brian Connell wrote a book in 1957 explaining all of that. But here is, again, if you want to go to my booklet on Germany's conquest of the Balkans, we'll give you the whole document that was declassified in 1996, and it lists 11 names of industrialists who dedicated themselves to bringing back Germany for World War III, if you can believe that. That included Messerschmitt, Rheinmetall, Volkswagen Werk, Krupp Industries, and there's 11 of them. I don't need to read all of them to you, but I'll tell you, there was a man on this earth that knew all about that. And he didn't have the document at all, but he knew what was happening, and God had revealed prophecy to him, and he was warning us even then of what was happening in Germany. Very few people listened, and they scorned him and scoffed at him in many ways. So after World War II, they thought, well, okay, we've won the war. But he said, have we really? He said, we don't understand German thoroughness. We don't understand that. And he had nothing, none of those classified documents to see and read as we have today. But these business leaders just keep coming and keep doing what Chancellor Angela Merkel talked about. She had no choice. She was helpless. Are they that powerful? They have been from the beginning. They put leaders in office. Now, this is their own history. Don't blame me if you don't agree with what something like this is saying. But the history there staring us all in the face. And that secret document is interesting because there's an article from the American Spectator which says America's fake European friends is the title of it. Finally, a U.S. publication is noticing how anti-American Europe is becoming. They zero in on EU's refusal to take a side between China and the U.S. Well, what about that? They don't want to show a favoritism toward the U.S. They're working with China. They're trading with them. They're getting close to them. Did you know that the Bible talks about people, our lovers, forsaking us, turning against us, and choosing China over America? That type thing. Read Jeremiah 4 and verse 30 and Ezekiel chapter 23, and you'll see about those lovers of Israel. It happens to be America and Britain primarily. If you don't understand that, write for our book on the United States and Britain in prophecy, and we'll send it to you. All of our literature is free. But we've been, Herbert Armstrong prophesied about this for over 50 years, telling us what was happening. T.H. Teton's wrote in 1953 about Germany plots with the Kremlin, where he said that only after Germany has established a great third bloc, power bloc. And he goes on to talk about that. But here's a man in our time, and notice what it says about him. For long, Carl Theodor zu Guttenberg has demanded that Europe will set up a third independent power bloc. Though he didn't use the exact same language, Europe seems to be implementing this policy now, right before they will what? Will they betray us? Well, that is suggested here in this news article. We have a booklet on a strong leader is imminent. A strong leader. They're looking for a leader. Europe is leaderless now, and they're looking for a strong leader, and they're going to find him. Daniel 8 and verse 23. Read it. This strong man that's going to understand dark meanings of what's happening in the world. And now there, it says here, an article, new push for an EU army from Germany. A new German-led push for an update to EU armed forces is being presented to EU leaders. And they know that many of them are not going to accept what they want to do in their way of running things. And it's going to get pared down to 10 kings. Prophesied that the prophecy I just read to you in Revelation 17. 10 kings. Will they rise in 2022 or 2023? I tell you, they're ready to rise right now. Here is a statement by Winston Churchill in a signed document with Franklin Roosevelt in February 1945, right after World War II. Here's what they said. It is our inflexible purpose to destroy German militarism and Nazism and to ensure Germany will never again be able to disturb the peace of the world. Because they'd already done it. They had already started two world wars. They had to stop this German military, but they didn't. They didn't even get close. That's what these events say, and that's what your Bible says. We have another book that we'll send you, Germany's Secret Strategy to Destroy Iran. They're going to destroy Iran. It's going to happen. And we have prophesied that for years, many years. And Germany is going to do just that. And they're going to have a great amount of power. And they're going to cause a lot of trouble in this world if we don't wake up and repent and listen to God in His prophecies. What does Angela Merkel mean when she says she is helpless to resist pressure from German business? So it's German business where those leaders, those with a Nazi spirit, are today. That's where they went underground. That's why nobody sees them. They're dressed like businessmen doing business, just technicians in these corporations. Or are they? Is that shocking to say that they are? That's what they are. And we need to know that. Mr. Tusk said this was her biggest mistake. And then it says she had no choice because of the pressure she was under from German business leaders. This Nazi spirit is still there. It's still there. And people, even Germans, don't realize what has really happened in most cases. Until next week, this is Gerald Flurry. Goodbye, friends.
All our materials are available free of charge, at no cost or obligation to you. Request He Was Right, Germany's Secret Strategy to Destroy Iran, and Strong Man Rising in Europe. Order now. The preceding program was a paid presentation of The Key of David, brought to you by the Philadelphia Church of God.